Electronica Center. Welcome again to Ars Electronica Home Delivery and our special concert series where piano music meets digital images. Summer has returned and here in Europe life is slowly going back to normal. In Austria, already museums, concert halls and theater houses have successfully reopened, and soon even the soccer stadiums will be allowed to open for their fans. So it seems to be quite a good timing that our concert series is coming to an end. And actually tonight is the final stop of our 2 months exciting journey through the wonderful world of piano music. And it's again a great pleasure for me to welcome and introduce our 2 guest artists, the 2 wonderful pianists, Maki Namekawa and Dennis Russell Davies. Thank you so much for this wonderful project.
We're really loving to be here.
Great. For tonight, they prepared a very special program that is actually dedicated to one of the most important living composers of Austria, to Kurt Schwerzig, who actually had his 85th birthday just yesterday. And later we will be able to send our wishes in the live talk with him on Skype. Kurt Schwerzig made a very big impact, not only with his music and his compositions, but also as an educator, and I think in particular as a relentless promoter of contemporary classical music, and that's why often he is referred to as the father of the Third Viennese School. Maki Namekawa and Dennis Russell Davies will now perform his 6 Macbeth pieces for piano 4 hands, which were actually composed in the late 80s for a quite spectacular dance theater production in Heidelberg in Germany. And the live visuals for this piece tonight will come from Gregor Woschitz. So without any further ado, please enjoy the evening, please enjoy the music. And, you know, since it's all about Macbeth, watch out if you can hear the bagpipes in the first piece.
Thank you.
bravo. Thank you very much for this full energy, this performance of really wonderful music. Thanks also to Gregor Woschitz for his really literally sparkling images that he created. And I think now we really have this wonderful pleasure to have the composer and the man who had his 85th birthday yesterday live in a Skype call. So let's play the funny game. Can you hear us?
Yes.
Wow, it works.
This is the first time it's really worked without an issue. It's perfect. Congratulations. You had a premiere yesterday on your birthday. What was that?
Yesterday I had a concert, just a surprise concert, more or less, because since Corona demolished all the performances, this was a surprise, yes. It was the Altenberg Trio played the first performance of a new piano trio. Wow.
At the Musikverein, Vienna.
In Vienna, at the Musikverein, right?
Musikverein, yep.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
Yeah, 100 persons in the audience, not more.
With appropriate distancing?
Yes, yes. It's a little bit spooky anyway. Yeah.
Well, I had concerts last week in Brno, and we're now able to sit quite close together, actually. The audience wears masks, but they can sit right. They can sit near each other. So things are, we're making progress.
This sounds very, very comforting.
We should have had a concert together at the end of May with your first violin concerto with Benjamin Herzl playing with the Philharmonie Brno, but we were, of course, victims of the lockdown. And we'll have to do it again another time. And we will.
Yeah. I met Herzl for the first time yesterday. He was in the concert. But we will have it in Linz, I think, performance.
In November.
In November, yeah.
Right. Yes, indeed. Kurt, do you remember when we first met?
Not the year, but it is quite a long time ago. It was for Fanverlieschen in Stuttgart.
That's right. I believe it was around 1984. 84 is when they opened their new chamber theater, the so-called Black Box. They had one there too. And that was for the opening, I believe. And
yes,
I was brought together with you by Klaus-Peter Kerr, who has been behind so many great collaborations and great composers over the years. And he also wanted me to bring in concert with the State Orchestra in Stuttgart, your Stark Deutsche Lieder.
Yeah, but before you had, I think, the flute concerto, wasn't it?
Instant music.
Yeah, instant music,
Absolutely right, yeah. I forgot, see, I'm not 85, I'm only 76, and I'm forgetting some things already. What are you writing now? What are you working on?
Just a little piece for viola and piano. But I just started, and it's hard going because, you know, all my ideas are exhausted already.
I don't believe that for a minute.
I have tried everything in my, but somehow I will manage.
I'm sure you will, and I'm so looking forward to when you're with us in Brno in October, because there we play for our American viewers and listeners today. We're playing a wonderful score that was also part of the ballet that we did together in Linz, based on Kafka's novel America, and you called the ballet Kafka America.
Yeah, the Kafka America. And the piece for orchestra, the pieces for orchestra, it's Mr. K discovers the USA.
Exactly. And also on that program, and it's a piece I've done a couple of times, I've delighted programming this piece next to a very long Bruckner symphony. And I'm talking about your Schrumpf symphony.
Yeah.
Could you tell the story about how that Schrumpf means shrunk for those who aren't German speakers? Schrumpf is shrunken. Why did you write a shrunken symphony?
Yeah, it was for Sylvester, the night before the New Year in 2000. There was a concert of the Camerata in Salzburg, and the renowned conductor, the English conductor, I forgot his name, I'm sorry, 85. But he wanted new compositions. And so 5 minutes of not more than 5 minutes. And I thought it would be nice to have a whole symphony in 5 minutes.
Well, you did it. Amazing. It's amazing because the whole thing is there, a sonata allegro form in the first movement. And the whole piece, I think, is 2 minutes and 10 seconds or something. It's really, it's extraordinary. It's brilliant.
Actually, I just would have a question concerning the Macbeth pieces. Were they actually composed for this dance theater production, or did you compose them earlier? So they were commissioned for this production.
Yeah, it was written for the dance theater production of Kresnik. And I took some pieces out of it to have it performed in concert.
Great.
That's what it is now.
And now a question to both of you, because Dennis asked me to mention the bagpipes, so maybe you can elaborate on the story of the bagpipes in the...
The Staatsspey is the inevitable sound of the bagpipes. Yeah. With this pedal tone on the low A and the very tricky little melodic things that go very well if you're playing an instrument like that. They're harder on the piano.
And it's really great how you can simulate the sound of a bagpipe on the piano. Really exciting.
Kurt, I wanted to also tell another story. You may remember when you wrote the symphony for us for the radio symphony in Vienna. And I was taking it with us, and I took it with us on our U.S. tour. And when I got the piece, it had a different title. Do you remember? You wrote on the title, Kurt wrote, it was called Sinfonietta. And I complained that I hated, I said, this is a difficult piece. It's a substantial piece. It's at least 20 minutes long. It's not an etta. It's a symphony. So what did you do? Do you remember what you did?
Yeah, yeah. It's a Sinfonia Sinfonietta.
He wouldn't let go of it. So I didn't have a Sinfonietta. I had a Sinfonia Sinfonietta.
I was never a composer who wanted to write a symphony. I'm shy of that title.
Is that because, you know, what we haven't talked about is Kurt was a brilliant horn player. And for years was a hornist in the Vienna Symphony Orchestra. You played enough symphonies back then, I suppose.
Yeah, I like to play in symphonies. Yeah, it was very nice. Yeah.
I remember. And which composers came when you were playing in the orchestra? And did they know you were in the orchestra?
Sometimes, yeah, sometimes. No, I don't remember. We had a lot of composers. We had the first that who comes to mind is Michael Tippett, who was almost blind at that time and wasn't a very good conductor anyway. But with the orchestra, he somehow managed to give the whole thing a drive.
Well, that's great. Did he know you? Did he know you were there?
No, not at all. No, not at all.
Very nice.
Another composer who conducted these things was Aaron Copland. I was still with a Tonkünstler, the Lower Austrian Tonkünstler, and Aaron Copland wanted to get to know young Austrian composers. And so he invited us to Sacher. And we played a few compositions of ours to him. And I was not so lucky because there was a dinner afterwards, but I had to go to the orchestra again. I had to play.
He was a
delightful person. He was very witty and everything. That's good. Yes.
Yeah, and very supportive of younger composers too. It was wonderful. Yeah.
Generous man. And,
What was the why? Gerfried mentioned the third Viennese school. Did you agree with that name? What did you think about that?
We never discussed that, but we had a festival in London once, and it was called not the third Viennese school.
Okay, that's good. And it was you and Nali and Friedrich Cerha?
Cerha, yeah, and a few others.
Zikan.
I can't remember really.
Zikan?
Zikan might. I don't think that he was part of the of that band. No.
Okay.
Maybe it was not the Viennese school, but Schuletta.
Yeah.
Using your way of doing.
Very a good idea. Yeah.
Thank you very much for all the wonderful work that you did in all your great career. Thanks for spending the time amidst all the celebrations that I'm sure are going on. Probably also the weekend you will have more celebrations. And it was really great to be able to perform your music and have you live here in our concert. And we are continuing the concert now. I hope you can stay a little bit and listen to it. And now we are changing a little bit the setup because the next two pieces will be performed by Maki Namekawa solo on the piano. And we are actually moving from Vienna to Amsterdam. Maki has brought two exciting pieces from a rather young Dutch composer, but maybe you can introduce it, please.
Okay. I will present tonight beautiful composer who is living in Holland. His name is Joop de Wing. I hope my pronunciation is perfect. I practiced today. Joop de Wing. This composer, beautiful composer, I knew him through my beloved friends, music friends, and beautiful ensemble, Cello Octet Amsterdam. They're watching today. Hi. In Amsterdam, and they played every time the concert Joop de Wing's beautiful piece Hanging D. This piece is actually for piano solo, but Cello Octet Amsterdam made their original version for cello octet. This is so wonderful, and when I didn't meet this ensemble Cello Octet Amsterdam, I watched once in YouTube their video, playing video. It was like taking breath, and I never forget this kind of shock. This is beautiful performance, and you can also watch it on YouTube, Hanging D. And then I will play today another piece too by Joop. It calls Midwayer. His piece, when I play, every time his music makes wakes me up, my emotion, which I actually every day I don't know. It is sleeping or staying very deep in my side. And you know, probably I can't talk everything with words and this kinds of emotion, not only sad, not only happy, not only missing something, but if I play his music, wakes my this kinds of emotion up. And every time, take me like this. I'm so happy to share with you today his beautiful two pieces. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Again, a really exciting performance. It's beautiful, incredible how this piece really is unfolding energy, or the first piece that is really going so deep into the heart, actually. And I'm sure many of our audiences have the same feeling, just being overwhelmed by not only the beautiful music, but I think in particular by the wonderful performance of the two of you. And I would like Dennis also to join us again for the chat session with our audiences on YouTube, Facebook, Skype, and any way you find to connect to us. And we start again with lots of greetings that I see on the screen already from New York, from USA, Linz and Luftenberg, from Rijeka in Croatia, and many more. And there are also first questions coming. If not piano, which instrument would you like to play?
I often think about that when I'm with the orchestras. I think I would like to be a double bass player.
And Maki?
Cello.
Cello, okay. Mm. Well, then at least you could play together in the orchestra.
And you have to come back with
Great. There is another question now from Facebook. How do you as musicians see and feel the visuals?
To tell you the truth, we're don't have time to really follow them when we're playing. We're involved in it before we have a chance to, after a rehearsal, which we usually are able to record, then we have a chance to see what the visuals are. And of course, tomorrow we will look at the program and watch again and enjoy them. But actually, our performance is not directly affected by the visuals, and the geniality of these visuals is that our playing affects the visuals. It's the other way around.
I'm watching live when I play Corey Oland's piece, and then like the first piece by Yop, it like jazz sessions, like something like jazz sessions. It goes like this, and then I can move like this. I can give more than visuals going like this way. I love this, but yeah, you're true. We are watching before the concert, by the rehearsal, and then after the concert at home, we enjoy it a lot. To watch it. Beautiful.
I think it's a very important part, this kind of triangle between the music, the live performance, and the visuals that really in a very nice way interacting with each other. I think we saw it also today in the first piece that had actually a lot of live performance by the visual artist with a lot of interfaces and using his own body and hands. Mm. So it's really very nice how these things come together. Yeah. And before I talk too much, let's go to more questions here. We have a lot of greetings again. Maestro Davies, liebe Grüße, best greetings from Korea.
Nice.
And Renata from Facebook says, happy birthday to Kurt Schwerzig. Many more years and lots of compositions. Nice. What's the next one? Comment from YouTube. How does it feel for you to have your audience not in front of you, but disconnected or connected only via internet? Question we had quite often actually in these sessions. And how is it really for you to play in an empty room, more or less?
Well, first of all, Gerfried, you're here. We have the crew here. And we feel the listeners are with us. These microphones are, in the best sense, hot. And we've had enough wonderful feedback to know that our music, our performance, is reaching a lot of people worldwide. So it's a live performance for us. So it's really very stimulating and enjoyable.
I feel sometimes very similar, like with my parents who is living in Tokyo. I'm not going to see every day, but I'm thinking of them, and then I can't see the audience, but then I feel something. It's beautiful.
And I have to say, I had the chance very often to see you on stage in front of big audiences, and also now actually 9 concerts long here in our piano room. And it's always, you know, exciting and really stunning how you really switch into this mode of being just music, being the interpreters, no matter whether it's here in this kind of studio or really on a big stage. So
very,
it's really exciting.
Here, but
and I can also personally say that it's very important for me to play well when I'm with her.
I admit. Thank you.
I just saw another question here to both of you, Maki and Dennis. Have you ever tried yourself to try your hand at composing? What about you as composers?
Never. I'm smart enough. I'm not going to start conducting and composing. No.
When I was very young, of course, I tried, but very young, and I quickly realized that was not going to be my métier. And plus, I had the opportunity to be with so many wonderful composers that I thought this is a better way to go for me to help them.
Yeah, you make many arrangements too.
Well, that's another, of course.
Another.
So what makes you more nervous is the next question, playing for large audiences or for distinguished colleagues?
What is this?
Große Künstler, große Meister.
I don't care.
It's the same for you. She has nerves of steel. It's really true. I've had both experiences, and it's something you have to really just focus. But of course, when you know that colleagues and especially friends,
when the composers are there.
And if the composers themselves aren't too nervous and actually are able to listen to what we're doing, that's also very nice.
Really great. So here we have, I know by now, a very great fan of you. Hiroko has made many comments in this series of concerts. Thank you for the wonderful concert over the last few weeks. They were full of variety and exciting energy. Now we are lost on Friday nights.
Well, I will call you.
That's maybe now a good moment to announce something that actually I reserved for the end. This is the end of this series where we play every Friday here from the Ars Electronica Center. But since it makes so much fun and we could gather such a large audience, we already agreed to somehow continue these concerts. We have already the plans for July and August to have at least one concert every month. And I think the dates will be July 14th and August 21st. So please already mark it in your calendar and join us again here for our concerts. So another question from Facebook. Dennis and Maki, you sound wonderful. Best show of all in our opinion of the series. Hi from your good friends in Bardstown, Kentucky. Sam and Petian.
Okay.
Sam and I have been friends. I think I was 6 years old when I met him, and his family lived one street away from where my house was. And we've been close ever since.
Yeah. And then he's the first chamber music company with, he played with you together.
We played in, we were together in the Libby High School Orchestra. Sam was a violinist and I was the pianist of the orchestra.
Yeah. You see?
Yeah. Well, that's the great thing then about the internet. I mean, you can have all the friends all over the world joining you at your concerts, and it's a German name, Margareta, but somebody who knows Japanese, danke schön, domo arigato gozaimasu. I'm sure this goes directly to Maki and Dennis. And I don't know if we have many more questions, because I think we are slowly running out of time, and we should continue with our program. Again, you have prepared a wonderful farewell for the last concert. Dennis, what will it be?
This was, of course, 2020 was the year of the great Beethoven celebration, which got off to a splendid start all over the world until roughly mid-March, when at the latest things ground to a halt. So a lot of wonderful performances haven't been able to take place, and we hope that things will start up again everywhere slowly and safely. But we thought we might play a wonderful piece that Beethoven actually composed for his opera Fidelio. It's the trio from the second act. And it has a really wonderful, wonderful title, and it's very appropriate. to what euch werde lohn in besseren Tagen, which could roughly be translated into English in hang in there, your reward is coming. That's a very rough English translation, but it's really, we'll have our reward in better days.
Thank you.
And usually this would be the moment where we say, bravo, thank you, and start to dismantle everything and go home. But since this is the last edition of this wonderful journey, we thought we might celebrate it a little bit. And in particular, it's a big pleasure to invite all the people behind the scenes, the people behind the camera, behind the audio equipment, doing the Skype and Zoom connections and organizing everything. So please join us. And I hope, yes, please don't hesitate.
Come.
Gregor, come. Oh. Also, thanks for the visuals today.
Bravo.
Vivian, Thomas, Wolfgang, please all join us. Let's keep the distance. And yes, of course, thank you very much to our wonderful artists.
Yes. Thank you. Congratulations to you.
And bye-bye. We hope to see you with our next concerts in July and August. As I mentioned already, we are dedicated to continue our broadcasting here from the Ars Electronica Center. Thanks and bye-bye. Now somebody has to switch off.